Welcome back inside my ever-expanding, ever-growing endurance fitness cave. I'm Dave Erickson. I got a new piece of equipment that I want to showcase for you. This is an indoor cycle with a 35-pound flywheel, basically a spin bike. And it's a great piece of exercise equipment for anyone who's beginning to get into their fitness routine or getting back on the fitness train after some time off. I'll give you a little demonstration here and just talk about what this bike has to offer. So let's get started. Here's a quick time lapse of me putting the bike together, which really didn't take as long as I thought it might. Only really a few pieces to contend with, but overall maybe 20, 30 minutes at most. And really you're looking at the seat post, the handlebars, and the pedals mostly, and of course also the instrument device on the very top. But other than that, it was a really quick build. Now the tour of the bike, of course, here's the handlebars, and here is your electronic device that shows your time, speed, calories, distance, odometer, and so on. It takes a couple of AAA batteries, and there's a cable here that connects to it. This knob in front adjusts the height of the stem. The pedals have adjustable cages on them. You can just go upside down if you want or just unscrew them completely, but these are a great way just to keep your feet in position. In fact, when I started doing triathlon back in 1998, one of my first races, I had cages on my road bike. I also had aero bars extended on my road bike as well, but that's a longer story. Nowadays, I'm just using regular clip-in pedals, but these cages are great for anybody because you can use your tennis shoes. This seat is also adjustable, again, pulling this and going up and down, and the seat itself slides back and forth, knob here, and you can do the adjustment this way to fit your body size and type. There's a spot here for a water bottle or some sort of hydration. Just above the water bottle is your tension knob. This is what you turn to the right to make it a little bit harder, a little left to make it a little easier for the spin wheel, and pressing it in for a quick stop. So if you are going pretty fast and you want to stop, press it in for an emergency or fast stop. Okay, let me get on. All right, once you get going on your spin bike, if you do notice any wiggle with the handlebars or the post, you just have to tighten the knob a little more, and that puts it firm into place. So you might notice some shakiness when you get going, but that's not a big deal. Now it's nice and sturdy. Very quiet bicycle as well. And you can probably see there are some wheels up front, so you can easily maneuver this around your workout space. And what I like about it is you have the display, which also has a spot you can put an iPad or any kind of device or your phone. If you want to look at it right there, there's a little slot to put it in front. I had the same kind of slot on my air resistance fan bike as well. And really easy to navigate and figure out what's going on here. You just press into mode to go through all the different data fields that shows speed, time that you've been riding, distance, calories, and so on. So this is really easy and self-explanatory, pretty intuitive. One of the things I really like about indoor cycling and spin bikes is the safety feature and convenience. Because if you're in a climate that has some challenging weather, wind, rain, whatever, snow, just get on your bike inside and get your workout in. Plus, there's no traffic, there's no noise, you can set up hydration, you can watch some TV or some Netflix, some binge watching, you put a fan in front of you if it's too hot. And you can just kind of get in your zone and work out. Plus, if you don't have much time, it saves you time having to get all dressed up, go outside and try to find a place to ride. You just pop on the bike, do a nice little 20-minute spin to start your day, and you are really good to go. In my opinion, this is a great starter bike for those who are looking for an economical way to get into cycling, fitness, and considering, especially with all the expensive options out there right now, if you are into some of the other bikes and products out there, they also have apps. So if you wanna join in on some of those other group rides, but you don't wanna spend the thousands of dollars on their bicycles, just buy their app and then ride along with them on your bike here. There you go, from Ativa Fit, great spin bike. Check it out, link below this video.